So, hello, hello everybody. How are you doing today? I hope you're doing well. Welcome back to my channel. If you are new to this channel, hello, my name is Mahala Undergachu. So, welcome to my channel. Here I talk about mainly art things, a little bit of college sprinkled in, a little bit of lifestyle stuff. So, hope you enjoy and be sure to subscribe to my channel and like this video if you liked it. So today, I wanted to talk to you guys about kind of like a recap of the first month of college, my experience, even though it's been like 2 months now. we won't talk about that, it's fine. At least I have more knowledge. So, I hope you guys enjoy. I think I'm going to do a little bit of drawing while talking. And yeah, let me know if you guys enjoy the video. And I'll see you in the next clip. So this is just going to be pretty much like the same kind of format as my sketch and chat with me video. So I'm just going to be talking about whatever I feel like talking about and then show you clips of me drawing at the same time. And yeah, so please enjoy. So first, starting off with, I'm just going to talk about my experience and what happened. So let me think. I think I moved in like the week before class started. So I came to school about August 11th. So I arrived around August 11th or so. And pretty much for UNCSA, we had a week before classes started for orientation, for just getting used to the environment. And I think it was honestly really helpful to have that week to really get to know the place without having like the craziness of school happening at the same time. And also move in, which was a lot. So with moving in, specifically because of COVID and everything, it was staggered. So each group of people had a different date to move in on. So mine was on a Tuesday, I think. And pretty much how it worked, you have like 2 hours to move in, which didn't seem like a lot when I first heard about it, but actually was a good amount of time to move in. So I had to haul all my shit up 3 flights of stairs, which was so fun. And I had to move in, unpack everything, and thankfully my parents were staying in town for a couple days so that if I had extra stuff, I could just give it to them. But thankfully, everything actually ended up fitting really well because I think my roommate and I, we got like a super single room that was meant for a single person, but then they put 2 beds in, I don't really know. But I think we got a larger room than average, which was kind of nice. So I had a lot of space to put everything, and yeah, and I also have a lot of clothes, so that was very good. There was a lot of space. So the move-in process was so hectic, and it's very nerve-wracking. Of course, when you're first getting on campus, it's like terrifying, because that was literally the first time that I, or actually no, because a few days before, my parents and I, we drove around just to see the environment, and I was like, this is so beautiful. Like, I was like in love with the campus. And then moving in, you don't really have time to talk with people or like meet new people. It's just like go, 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 go. Like, you're on a strict schedule, and orientation is like not really orientation. You just pick up like a few bags and go. So very hectic. I remember sweating my ass off because it was like 90 degrees outside. And then so yeah, so once I got moved in, after that I was like talking with my roommate because that was like the first time we had met. So it was really fun to like get to know her, and we were like walking around campus and we were like, you know what, let's go around different places, let's meet some people. So that is the one thing. I'm gonna be putting in like sprinkles of advice here and there. So one of the main things that I learned from this first month is try to meet as many people as possible. Like, I know it's a lot, like a lot of pressure, but honestly it's really nice to like broaden your range to everybody so then you know who to not hang out with, like you know who you don't want to vibe with, you know. So definitely, like, also another thing, I really recommend journaling, because I used to never journal or anything like that, and then I was like, you know what, I want to document like every day so that I can look back on it. And now I'm like really thankful, so I have like this little journal. And it's so interesting to see like how much things changed in a month. Like, the people I was talking about in my journal, I was like, oh my god, this seems so nice. And then later on I found out, I was like, ooh, I do not want to associate myself with them. So it's good to honestly meet as many people as possible. Just have fun and don't stress too much about like putting the right impression on people because everybody's scared, everybody's freaking out and nervous about like what to do. So like during your first month or like your first week on campus, everybody is very sociable, at least in my experience, and everybody really wants to get out and meet people and hang out and like find new people to talk to. So yeah. And one also thing I learned was that it's good to be friends with people outside of your major. So with me especially, I'm really thankful my roommate is a film major, because I met like all of her friends and I'm able to collaborate with a lot of her film projects, and she can collaborate with a lot of my things. So I really recommend go outside of your major and talk to other people outside of your major, because it's very fascinating to learn how, even though we're all in a creative space, everybody thinks differently. And each of the different departments, they have very different kind of personalities almost. So definitely recommend going outside of your room as much as you can before school starts, because once classes start, it gets a bit harder to socialize, but I'll get more into that later. And also, if you guys haven't realized by now, this is gonna be a very rambling video. I'm just gonna talk. I don't really have anything planned, so we'll see how that goes. So yeah, after my first week, I was already feeling very comfortable in my space, probably because I brought a lot of stuff from home that made me feel like I was at home. So I brought a lot of memorabilia, I brought my giant teddy bear in the background, as you can see, which is honestly probably one of the best things I've brought here. Christmas lights do a lot of good for your dorm as well, because it really like makes the room very cozy. So just like little things here and there really just brighten the mood and allow you to feel like even though you're far away from home, you still have a piece of home in your heart, kind of. Oh yeah, so my class schedule, this year I'm taking five classes. So I'm taking one DLA class, and DLA means Division of Liberal Arts. So those are like your basic academic classes. And thankfully in high school, because I took a lot of AP classes, even though it was hell, it really helped because I got out of a lot of classes. Like there's one class called First Year Seminar, which is like your basic like freshman writing class, and I got to get out of that and another writing class, which was awesome. So definitely if you're watching this and you're still in high school, take as many APs as you can and make sure the credits transfer, because even though it's exhausting at that time, it's really gonna help you out, because then you'll be able to take the classes you're more interested in at a quicker pace. So like for me, I never have to take another math class in my life again, which I am so grateful for. So my classes this year, I have one DLA called Narrative Medicine, which is a very interesting class. It's like talking about combining writing with the medical field. So that's very interesting. Those are my 9 a.m. classes, Monday, Wednesday, Friday. And then I'll just go through the week. So Mondays, I have Narrative Medicine at 9 a.m. And then I have drafting class from 11:20 to 1 p.m. And that class is, if you are like interested in design production, you probably already know, drafting is like kind of like blueprinting, I guess, but for set design and for theater design. So you'll be taking that if you're a props major, if you are a scenic tech or a scenic design, and if you are a lighting major as well. I think that's all of them. So that's a good class. And then Tuesdays I have color and design class from 10 a.m. to 11:20 a.m. and then intro to theatrical production class from 3:30 to 4:50 p.m. And then Wednesdays I just have one class, which is my DLA again. Thursdays is the same as my Tuesday schedule, so color and design and then intro to theatrical production, or we call it ITP. And then Friday I have my DLA class again and then drafting again. So it's kind of a repetitive schedule, but also it's really nice to give you a lot of time in between classes to either like chill or you can work on homework. And then usually I think because one, I'm a first year, and also because of COVID, we didn't have production like at all for the first month, at least for the first years in props, because they had to decrease the capacity of students, I think, maybe something like that. And also probably because we're first years and we don't know shit, so. So I didn't have production until literally 2 days ago, which I'll get into that later, maybe. So your first month of classes will be just a very interesting experience. It's all the faculty here are really incredible. Like, you will learn very quickly that they are very passionate about teaching and very passionate about helping their students and really like guiding you along the way. And of course, they're not going to hold your hand every step of the way, but they're very helpful if you have any questions, if you're just confused about the class, or if you need help in some area. Like, they will be very willing to reach out to you, or they'll be very willing to help you if you reach out to them. So yeah, pretty much my first month of college was very interesting, especially I'll say in a pandemic. I feel like for some reason everybody here for the most part takes it very seriously about distancing and wearing masks 24/7. Like, you will make your friends, like, just don't worry about it. And and your classes as well, like, you're able to talk to people around you and just try to get outside of your comfort zone, because that was the main thing for me. My main goals when I came here was, okay, I'm gonna get out of my comfort zone, I'm going to talk to people more often, because me compared to old high school me is very different. Because I was very, I wouldn't say I was like super antisocial, but I tended to stick with my friend group and like not talk to anybody else, and I was always scared of people judging me. But here, nobody's really gonna judge you. Like, you will find your people. So just don't worry about not making friends quickly enough, or if you see people, oh, they're already friends, I have to make friends. Like, don't worry about it. Just go with the flow, honestly, that's the main thing. And just be okay with whatever happens. Be open-minded to everything, you know? Yeah. So also, I forgot to mention that most of my classes are actually in person, because there's a large classroom, so we're all able to space out. So the only class I have online is my DLA class in the morning, and then on Thursdays, all those classes are online, because it's like kind of a hybrid. So yeah, I wanted to mention that to get some like clarification on how they've been doing with COVID and such. But surprisingly, like, our school's been doing pretty well. Like, so far, right now, we don't have any cases of corona, hopefully, like, for a while. And everybody's very adamant about, like, being sure to follow the guidelines, even though there are some people who don't follow them. But, you know, I just avoid them, so it's fine. So, also, I really wanted to talk about the whole, like, roommate situation, because I know before I came to college, I was, like, really worried about picking a roommate, if I'll vibe with my roommate, if like everything will go okay. So in regards to like roommate, how I pick my roommate, and so on for specifically for UNCSA, there was a housing application website, and that was where you picked your roommate. And so thankfully they had, I think most colleges, they'll have a survey that you take just to like get to know, so everybody else like gets to know who you are, so like you give your preferences, like for example, like if you want the room hot or cold, if you work late at night, if you wake up early in the morning, what you like to do, like your hobbies. And then from there, the website will give you a list of possible compatible roommates with like percentages, which is kind of like weird, like kind of like Black Mirror-esque, but so it'll give you people who have like the highest ranking, like who are highest match to you, and then going down the list. And so for me personally, I really wanted to pick a film major as my roommate, because I really wanted to like work on film projects and like get into that field, because that's what I want to do with my props, is go into the film industry. So that was like my main thing. I was like, I want to get somebody in film. So how about my roommate? She is amazing. Like, it was, I think I was really lucky with choosing her, because we have very similar interests, and when we were talking, she was very friendly and everything. So pretty much once you choose, like usually I chose like a few people that I thought we would match well together, and then I messaged them on Instagram, and I was like, hey, this is who I am, I was wondering if you want a room together, or we can talk a little bit, get to know each other. And then from there, usually it's like, I remember it was so awkward, because it just felt like an interview or something. Like, do you party at night? Do you like to wake up early in the morning? Do you like going out or staying inside? Because like, I wanted a very specific like kind of person, kind of. Like, I wanted somebody who's extroverted and like talkative and outgoing and like ready to go out places, but not like party all night, you know? So usually it took a long time to find my roommate, but I'm very glad I found her, because she's amazing. Shout out to you, Camilla. So yeah, with the whole situation, it takes a long time kind of to get used to things, and also sometimes people would be like chatting with you. It happened to me once where somebody was talking with me, we were about to become roommates, and then she stopped talking to me, and then a few weeks later she was like, I actually found somebody else, and I was like, okay. But in the end, it usually turns out for the better. And if you end up having like a crazy roommate, you can always switch roommates. That is a possibility as well. So far, I haven't heard any like terrible roommate stories here. Of course, you have your few people, but for the most part, if you choose people who like match well with your preferences, and you talk and they seem like a cool person, usually that'll work out pretty well. And if not, then like it'll be okay. It's just your dorm is just a place where you sleep. And you don't have to like study here 24/7, like you can go other places, so it's not the end of the world if you get somebody who is not like your best buddy. So yeah, that's like one of the advice that I was given, was don't expect your roommate to be your best friend. Like, just go with the flow, and if they want to be your friend, that's cool, but if they don't, that's okay too. So thankfully my roommate is like not one of my like best friends here. So yeah, that's my tidbit about the roommate situation. So yeah, specifically, I'm just going to speak as a props major at UNCSA, like that specific area, or at least like DMP major at UNCSA. So your first month, usually it'd just be like a lot of syllabus work, of course like in the first week or so. And then they give a good amount of work. In the beginning, it's not too bad. It really depends like how well your work ethic is. So I'd really suggest, if you don't have that great of a work ethic before coming to college, I really recommend like you try different strategies of like note taking, or get an agenda, because I have an agenda and it's like the like my existence. Like I would die if I didn't have an agenda. I'd really recommend like you really, when you come here, you have to be like a good worker, kind of. Like, you can't procrastinate. I mean, you can procrastinate, but it's really just not good for your mental health to push everything to the end. So it's really good to learn how to pace yourself and stay organized, stay calm, and when things start to pile up, just like be able to know how to deal with that pressure, you know? So yeah, but it's not too much work in the first month, I think. I think it definitely varies from major to major. Like, for example, for prof specifically, it wasn't that bad, honestly, for me. But I think that's because I've like already established a good work ethic, so I was able to keep everything balanced. And I know like also for film majors, they had a rough, I'll say that, they got a lot of work. So if you're watching this and you're a film major, you better have a good work ethic, because they got a lot to do. So those are the only two majors I really like know a lot about, like those areas, because my roommate's a film major, so I hear everything from her and her friends. But I don't really know that much about like dance or drama or music, so sorry about that. I can't really provide that input, but yeah. If you have any questions, you can ask them in the comments, and I'll ask some people around campus and see if they'll be willing to answer your questions. So overall, first month of college is definitely a big one. It's very hectic, very stressful, and scary, but you'll adjust quickly. Like, if you're like how I am, I tend to adapt very quickly to my environments. So just the main things is like, also be sure to keep in touch with your family and your friends like back home. Like, give them a call every once in a while, because that's one thing I noticed, is I'm not good with like calling other people, so I've been having to work on that to keep in touch with people back home, so like I don't get completely disconnected from them. So but overall, just be excited for your first month of college. It's very exciting. You're in a whole new environment, whole new people, friends, faculty that you can make connections with and be friends with. So just be excited. It's a really wonderful month, and yeah, I don't know. I had a really enjoyable first month of college. Right now it's about like 1.5 or so. Today it's like September 28th, so I'm a bit late making this video, but what can you do? I'm a busy gal. So yeah, I think that's all for today's video. If you have any questions, make sure, like I said, leave in the comments below. I love to answer them and give you as much input as I can. I try to respond within like a week or so. I don't really get notifications if there are comments, so I try to check frequently. But be sure to comment, subscribe to my YouTube channel if you want more content like this. I'm gonna be making more college videos mixed with art, and more art-centered videos as well, so be just a mix of everything. And I'm hoping to make a portfolio video soon as well. I always say soon, I know, but it takes a while. So yeah, and also if you are interested in my art, be sure to follow me on Instagram at Kayla Miles. I don't know where I'll put the username, Kayla Miles. And I'd love to see you there. And yeah, I think that's pretty much it. So I hope you have a great day, and see you guys later. Bye.